So what do? You're sick and tired. You're sick and tired of feeling sick and tired. It feels like nobody really understands. The doctors think you're making it up, or maybe they're offering wrong solutions, or saying it's just blah, blah, blah. Discouraged. You want to whine a little bit, but you're figuring you're probably not supposed to whine. What are you supposed to do? How are you supposed to live with this day in and day out, and the nights, and the weekends, and the vacations, and everybody else is having a good time, and you're stuck with chronic pain, or you're stuck with dietary restrictions, or you're stuck with this condition and this condition, and a big long list of conditions that it feels like nobody wants to hear. What do you do? Well, Jesus once said that you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Well, how's the truth supposed to set you free if the truth is lousy? Well, I am a follower of Jesus Christ, and I believe that what the Bible says is the best and happiest way to live. And in it, it says that those of us that belong to Jesus, that have accepted Him, we get heaven. We have eternal life. We get to go be with God when we die. And in heaven, it says there's no more tears, there's no more sorrow, and there's no more pain. So I know that even if this isn't going to get better, and it usually does, stick it out the night, stick it out the week, stick it out the weekend, enjoy what you can, as much as you can, and it does usually get better. But even if it doesn't, what if you're in a wheelchair? What if you are terminal? This isn't the end. For anyone who belongs to Christ, this is just this little spot, and when it's over, all the bad stuff, every single bit of it, and not just the physical pain, all the conflict, all the regrets, all the sins, everything. Going because you know the good stuff is coming. But what about for today? What about for today? What about all the people that don't understand? What about when you feel completely alone? Having chronic illness is a very isolating thing. And even the other people who have chronic illness, they still don't understand your chronic illness. And even the people who have your chronic illness, they still don't understand how it's affecting you right at this moment. But the God who made you, He does understand. He actually knows it better than you do. The Bible says God knows the number of hairs we have on our head, and I don't know how many that is for mine. It's usually about 100,000, but you lose like 100 every day, so there's no way to keep track. And even if you knew how many there were right now, there's no way to keep track of how many you have tomorrow. So God actually knows you better than you know yourself. So when you are struggling, go to Psalm 139 and read what God says about you. In fact, I'd recommend take the verses and where it says he or I or my, put in your name. And see what He has to say for you and about you and to you so that you can live with hope. Because quite honestly, here in this world, there are times when there isn't enough hope to keep going. But always look out there. So know that what you're going through, it does have a purpose. It isn't the end. And you can